Good morning, student. Today here we describe or discuss about transport of food and other substances in plants. In earlier lecture, we explained there about how water and mineral transport from root to other part of the plant. Okay, there we also explained that how tracheids work and how. Pits work there, okay. Which type of dead cells are present in plant which support the plant and have to transportation in water and minerals. Now here as you seen there is a picture of phloem cells, means transport of food and other substances. The first question is here in our mind that leaf make food by the process of photosynthesis. Means the food made by leaves is in the form of sugar. Or glucose, okay. And other type of substances called plant hormones are made in tips of the root and shoot. Now every part of the plant need food, so food mean made in leaves of the plant has to be transported to all part of the plant like branches, stem, roots, etc. And the food manufactured by the leaves of a plant is transported to it all part of the plant by kind of tubes like we call them phloem, which are present in all part of the plant. So the transport of food means those food which is made in leaves are transported from the leaves to the other part of the plant, that is called translocation. Okay, so phloem contain sieve tubes. As you see in your screen, there is sieve tubes. So like xylem vessel, phloem is made of many cells joined to end of end to form long tube. Means end wall of the cell which form phloem are not completely broken down. Means the end wall of cells in phloem form sieve plates, okay, and which have small holes in them. These holes in the sieve plate allow the food to pass along the phloem tubes, okay, and the cell of phloem are called sieve tubes. Means sieve tubes which form phloem are living cell which contain cytoplasm, but they do not contain nucleus. So the sieve tube cell do not have lignin in their wall, and each sieve tubes has a companion cell next to it. So the companion cell has a nucleus and many other organelles, and the work of companion cell to supply the sieve tube with some of their requirement. Okay, now the food is made in the mesophyll cell. We also call it photosynthetic cell of the cell of the leaf. So the food, like we told that food like sugar made by the mesophyll cells of the leaf enter into the sieve tubes of the plant. Means sieve tubes of the phloem, and interconnected phloem tube are present in all part of the plant. So once the food enter the phloem tubes in the leaves, is transported to other part of the plant by the network of phloem tubes, which is present in all part of the plant like in stem and roots. So the translocation of food, translocation means transportation of food in all part of the plant. So transportation of food from leaves to other part of the plant is necessary because every part of the plant need food for obtaining energy. Like all cells in human being need energy. At the same condition, plant parts also need energy for building its part and maintaining its life. Okay, so food is transported in plant through a network of phloem tubes, and then other substance by the plant like hormones also carried by the phloem tubes, which one part of the plant is to other part. Okay, so movement of water in xylem is always upward, and it is caused by the suction of water at the top because of low pressure created by the transpiration from leaves. And the movement of food in phloem can be upward or downward, means depending on the needs of the plant. So xylem always do unidirectional process, but phloem do a bidirectional process. Okay, so this is how phloem help to transport food material from plant to from plant's leaves to other part of the plant. Okay, so if you talk about the mechanism of transport of food in plant, so the movement of food in phloem takes place by utilizing energy. Means the sugar made in leaves is located in the nucleus of plant tissue, or by using energy from ATP. Water now enters the sieve tube containing sugar by the process of osmosis, and due to which the pressure of the phloem tissue rises, and the high pressure means the phloem tissue move the food to all part of the plant. Okay, so there is lots of question related to it, but today we take test from topic respiration and nutrition. I send you one PDF of these questions. You have to be need to sort out by your own, okay? And send to me in PDF form in same group. Okay, this is now transportation of food. Transportation in human being and transportation of food is over here. In our next lecture, we have to be started new chapter how do organisms reproduce, because life process is the first term examination syllabus, though, so that's why we take some questions from this to short out and discuss our problem. Okay, thank you.